वादे तो किए गए थे 100 दिन में गारंटीज को पूरा करने की, लेकिन एक महीना ही हुआ है पार्लियामेंट के इलेक्शन होकर। तो मैं अपनी जानिब से, अपनी पार्टी की जानिब से ये ज़रूर कहना चाहूँगा कि हम हुकूमत को तनखीद का निशाना बनाए बगैर ये समझते हैं कि वक्त देना ज़रूरी है, और कुछ वक्त ज़रूर देंगे आप अपने वादों को पूरा करने के लिए जो आपने आवाम से किया, और वक्त ही फैसला करेगा, और वक्त के साथ फैसला आवाम के हाथ में होता है। चाहे कोई भी इख्तदार में रहो, मैं किसी की तरफदारी या किसी की मुखालिफत के लिए आज यहां खड़ा नहीं हूं। चाहे बीआरएस हो या बीआरएस से पहले कांग्रेस हो या फिर तेलुगुदेशम थी आंध्र प्रदेश में, तो हर हुकूमत की कोशिश यही रहती है कि काम हो और अच्छे काम हो। कोई अच्छे काम भी करता है तो कोई खराब या बुरे काम भी करता है, लेकिन आखिर में फैसला आवाम देती है और आवाम फैसला करती है कि किसको हुक्मरानी का हक व इख्तियार दिया जाना चाहिए। काम बीआरएस ने किया। मैं सुन रहा था तकरीर हरीश राव साहब की, कई कामयाबियों को उन्होंने बयान किया कि उनकी जानिब से, उनकी पार्टी की जानिब से हुए, लेकिन आवाम ने फैसला दिया कि कांग्रेस को मौका दिया जाएगा, वो हुकूमत करेगी और आवाम की खिदमत करेगी। तो मैं आज अपनी तकरीर को जारी रखते हुए हमारे फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर साहब विक्रमा भट्टी साहब को मुबारकबाद देता हूं कि वो पहला बजट अपना उन्होंने पेश किया, और ये भी ज़रूर कहूंगा कि 107 पेजेस का एक मैराथन बजट उन्होंने पेश किया। एंड आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू रिमाइंड एंड रिकॉल एंड से दिस दैट भट्टी साहब हैज़ बीन द मेंबर ऑफ द हाउस सिंस 2009 एंड ही हैज सर्व्ड एज अ चीफ विप and also he has served as a deputy speaker in the United Andhra Pradesh and also as a Congress floor leader in Telangana Assembly in the last 5 years. He is a man of a wide experience. He has tried to prepare the Telangana state budget to the best of his ability. I may say that he has lot of insight into the financial situation of the Telangana government since the formation of the state, as he has participated in the debates in this house earlier under the leadership of Jana Reddy Saab and later as the floor leader of the Congress. Now Bhatti Saab says that 10 years after its formation, Telangana has not progressed as expected. He says that the previous government failed on all fronts, and development of the state and the welfare of the people suffered, and the state was pushed into a debt trap. He points out that it was a huge challenge for the new Congress government to manage the state, which was in financial shambles. Sir, when I say this, I would also like to say that the financial situation of the state was not hidden. It was very open. Every budget session we used to debate on that. Every appropriation bill we used to have a discussion, and a healthy discussion. I still remember and recall, I was also in the house when Mr. Jana Reddy Saab was a LOP that time, leader of opposition. I remember him using a sentence and saying that the state is in a financial emergency state. So I don't understand. When I was coming to attend the assembly, sir, I was hearing Harish Rao Saab's speech, and then I was also hearing a reply by the finance minister. He was saying, like he was saying in Telugu, if I have to translate, uska matlab ye tha ki aapne to aisa hal kar diya ki tankha dene ko paise nahi hai. To sawal ye paida hota hai, ye situation aapko malum nahi tha, आपको दिखाई नहीं दे रहा था या किताबों में लिखा हुआ नहीं था, था ये फाइनेंशियल सिचुएशन है और इनकी ये नाकामी है, इसलिए तो आपको ओढ़ दिया ना, इसलिए तो आपको वहां बिठाया। ये फाइनेंशियल सिचुएशन को देखते हुए, सीइंग द फाइनेंशियल सिचुएशन, यू हैव प्रॉमिस्ड टू द पीपल ऑफ द स्टेट कि वी विल डू दिस, वी विल डू दिस, वी विल गिव दिस, वी विल डू दैट, वी विल गिव यू दिस, व्हाटसोएवर हाउसोएवर द फाइनेंशियल स्टेट इज, इट इज द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट टू फुलफिल द प्रॉमिस, एंड आई एम श्योर दैट द कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट विल ट्राई इट्स लेवल बेस्ट एंड फुलफिल ऑल द प्रोमिसेज मेड टू द गवर्नमेंट। दिस इज वाई आई सेड के आई बिलीव इन गिविंग टाइम। सर व्हेन द फाइनेंशियल स्टेट इज, सर इफ दिस नैरेटिव ऑफ मिस्टर भट्टी साहब, फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर साहब, वेर ही सेज के डेप ट्रैप में है, ऐसा है वैसा है, तो आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क वन थिंग सर, अगेन आई वॉज रीडिंग द बजट स्पीच इन दैट, इफ आई एम रॉन्ग आई मे बी करेक्टेड सर। सर द स्टेट जीएसडीपी रोज फ्रॉम 4,51,580 crores in 2013 and 14, first year of formation of Telangana. Sir, I'm repeating, 4,51,580 crores, first year of formation of Telangana, to rupees 14,63,960 crores in the year 23-24, current prices. Sir, going further ahead, similarly the per capita income of the state rose from 1,12,162 in 2013 and 14 to from 1,12,162 in 2013 and 14 to 3,47,299 in the year 23-24. If I am wrong, I may be corrected. Sir, if the state economy was badly run and the state finances were mismanaged, then how do you explain the progress of Telangana in the last 10 years? How do you explain it, sir? So I am not coming for a rescue of the BRS party, sir. No, not at all, sir. Sir, I am bringing these figures and giving this message to the investors who are interested to come in the state, that our state is progressing, our state's health is very good, you can come, you can invest. But if we are going to just for political gains, target, and you know, just say that the state is in a bad state, state is in a very bad financial state, then how the investors would be coming? Sir, when I say this, sir, when I say this, sir, I am so saddened. I had seen a picture in which I saw that Honorable Chief Minister Saab was handing over the budget ka jo bag hota hai, basta hota hai, he was handing it over to Bhatti Saab. Bhatti Saab was there, ministers were there. Good. But I'm sure that Honorable Chief Minister Saab also might be part of the preparation of the budget. But I am so surprised, sir. I am so surprised when I spoke about the foreign investment or any investors coming. Sir, Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Revanth Reddy Saab, I think in one or two occasions, my learned friend, my colleague, my minister, Sridhar Babu Saab also was there with him. He had gone to Davos, right? And we have broken all the records. 40,232 crores of investment had come to Telangana. Am I right or wrong, sir? If I am wrong, Honorable Minister can, you know, rise and interrupt me and stop me from this. So to my surprise, sir, to my surprise and to the surprise of the House, not a single line has been mentioned in the budget. अरे आपका अचीवमेंट है साहब ये, व्हेन आई सेड दैट क्या आई एम विलिंग टू गिव यू द टाइम, आई एम विलिंग टू गिव यू द टाइम, एंड यू अ न्यू गवर्नमेंट रिक्वायर्स अ टाइम टू सेटल डाउन टू टेक अ डिसीजन, बट In no given time, you get an, you sign an agreement, you get an investment of 40,000, and that 40,000 doesn't have a place in the budget. So don't you think this is a height of ignorance? Don't you think this needs to be corrected? And I'm saddened. I've been hearing the Congress, I've been hearing the finance minister, I've been hearing so many ministers rebutting and countering. But unfortunately, not a single member from the Congress rose and said that, sir, this is our achievement in such a short time.
Sir, I would like to bring to the notice of honorable member, sir. Sir, in the month of February, where we had the vote on account session, we mentioned this aspect. We mentioned the achievement of this state. And we were very clear, and we thought, and we have put, this is a broad-based, outlook we have presented on behalf of the government here. And in fact, the additional sentence would have made an impact that has been rightly be taken, but we have already reflected in our earlier presentation of the budget in the February. I would like to bring to the notice of the kind member.
Honorable panel speaker, sir, I thank honorable minister, learned minister for legislative affairs for replying to me. But sir, I have a doubt. He said that it was mentioned. It should have been mentioned here also. So main ye janna cha raha hu, mere dil mein khayal aa raha hai, ho sakta hai ki kai logon ke dil mein bhi khayal hoga कि वो सही नहीं था 40,000, इसलिए इस मर्तबा करेक्शन करके नहीं लिखे. ऐसा तो नहीं है ना साहब, नहीं है ना साहब. वो भी सच था और मैं जो बोल रहा हूं ये भी सच है जी. नहीं नहीं, मैं देखिए, एक आपका अचीवमेंट है जिसको आप भूल गए, मैं आपके सामने ला रहा हूं. इसको तनखीद की नजर से ना देखें, इसको तामीर की नजर से देखें. कि मैं आपको कह रहा हूं कि आपका अचीवमेंट है इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम 40,000, सर, इट हैज ब्रोकन ऑल द रिकॉर्ड्स. सो दिस शुड हैव हैड अ प्लेस इन द बजट. आई नो इट वाज मेंशन्ड इन द ओटन अकाउंट, बट मेनी थिंग्स वेर मेंशन्ड इन द ओटन अकाउंट विच हैज बीन रिपीटेड अगेन इन दिस बजट ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज अ मिस्टेक विच हैज बीन डन. सो लेट अस एडमिट दिस मिस्टेक एंड से दैट के यस, वी हैव फॉरगॉटन, वी विल करेक्ट दिस एंड विल मेक श्योर दैट व्हेन द ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर गिव्स अ रिप्लाई ही विल मेंशन दिस. सर, sir, if the state economy was badly run or mismanaged, sir, then these answers needs to be given, sir. So secondly, sir, Bhatti saab complains that the previous government was inflating the figures and presenting unrealistic budget which sorely missed their targets. This also appears to be somewhat self-contradictory, sir, as the first full-fledged budget presented by him also contains unrealistic targets for the receipts and grants allocations and outlays, sir. So the full budget was presented almost 5 months after the vote on account budget was table in the house. The CAG provisional account for the year 23-24 financial year indicate that the state total receipts were 2,18,715 crores and the total expenditure was 2,11,854 crores. Honorable panel speaker, sir, Bhatti saab has quoted revised estimate for 23-24 while presenting the 24-25 full budget. Sir, I may recall that the Union Finance Minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman, has presented full-fledged Union budget this month while quoting the provisional account for the year 23-24 financial year. However, Bhatti saab quotes the revised estimate of receipt of rupees, revised estimate, sir, of rupees 2,26,095 crores and expenditure of rupees 2,31,017 crore for the financial year 23-24, which ends on 31st of March. Sir, if I am wrong, I may be corrected, sir. Sir, if we look at the budget estimate of 24-25, the total receipts are estimated at rupees 2,90,815 crores and the total expenditure is expected to be rupees 2,91,059 crores. The budget estimate for the year 24-25 do not represent a big jump over the revised estimate of 23-24, but they are in fact much higher compared to the actual accounts for the year 2023 and 2024. The only comparative figures in the revised estimate for the year 23-24, as per the Finance Minister Saab, and the account for the 23-24, as per the CAG, relates to the fiscal deficit or total borrowing, which are cited as 49,373 crores by Bhatti Saab and rupees 49,589 crore by the CAG. Bhatti Saab ek bolte hai, CAG ek bolta hai, sir. Sir, I may point out, sir, that the previous government has borrowed 38,151 crore during April-November 2023, sir, and in the remaining 4 months of the last financial year, from December 23 to March 24, the Congress government has borrowed 11,438 crores. If I am wrong, I may be corrected, sir. Now, between April and July 2024, in the current financial year, the borrowings have reached to 23,680 crores. Incidentally, the finance minister says that since coming to power, the Congress government raised 35,118 crores in the last 8 months. Sir, there are many inconsistencies and discrepancies in fact and figures that have crept into the 50-page budget speech of the finance minister Saab. So the receipts of the state government in 24-25 have been grossly overestimated. Under revenue receipts, the finance minister Saab has shown the state share in central taxes as rupees 26,216 crores and central grants in aid as rupees 21,636 crore. That is total central transfers of rupees 47,852 crores. So now again, honorable panel speaker, sir, however, in 23-24 financial year, the state received only 23,216 crores as share of central taxes and rupees 9,730 crores as grant in aid, totaling to rupees 32,946. Sir, we do not know what is the basis of the finance minister Saab enthusiasm and expecting rupees 21,636 crores as grant in aid in the current year. Here he seems to be so enthusiastic. And a day before, we had a discussion and a debate and also a resolution stating that we are not getting our due share. There we discuss and here we show so much of enthusiasm. So mujhe samajh mein nahi aa raha hai ki ye kaisa gap. And if we see what has been collected last year, or agar aap dekhte hain jo kami aa rahi hai, deficit aa rahi hai, usko kaisa pura karenge? I may be wrong, sir, but ye gap kaisa karenge, kaisa layenge, pata nahi. Shayad waisa hi lane wale hain jaisa old city mein Adani ko de rahe hain, to shayad they are helping. Shayad Adani. I might be wrong. Please do not feel offended. But I'm thinking. I mean, I'm samajh raha hu shayad. Shayad, wo bhi collection shayad Adani. Kuch karke denge shayad, I don't know. I hope I'm wrong. Similarly, the finance minister Saab has quoted ambitious targets for state-owned revenue targets for the year 24-25, including rupees 18,229 crores from stamps and registration, rupees 25,617 crore from state excise, rupees 33,449 crores from value-added tax, 8,478 crores from motor vehicle tax, rupees 715 crores from electricity dues, etc., totaling to rupees 86,518 crores. In 23-24, the state realized a receipt of rupees 72,503 crores from all these state taxes, and the state has to realize